where he was born absolutely fine. He was beautiful. Then he got to about just over 2 years old. We noticed that he was limping. Then probably a month after that, one morning, got him out of bed and he would not stand up. We didn't actually get a diagnosis until last year, when he would have been 10.
Lewis has a rare disease. It's a peculiar description because it's estimated that 3 million people in the UK are affected by rare diseases. They're far more common than you might think. There are over 6,000 different diseases, with more being discovered all the time. But each one affects just a tiny number of people, most of them children, like Lewis. There's been a welcome new focus on how to help diagnose and treat those with rare diseases. But first, what does it mean to be the parent of a child with a rare disease? Hi, Samantha. Nice to meet you.
Come in.
Thanks.
We had lots of ideas of what it could be. There were lots of tests, but then everything came back as either completely normal or negative for the testing. Right. So we just carried on with an undiagnosed child who was clearly very poorly, but according to all the tests, was absolutely fine.
If you or your child are poorly, your natural reaction would be to visit your GP, and you'd expect them to be able to diagnose the problem. But in the case of a rare disease, it's seldom that simple. When you're a medical student, you're taught common things occur commonly. Mm. So what will happen is that, quite rightly, your GP will say, well, it's probably this, and then they'll start doing tests when it turns out that's not the case. Yeah. And often, it's a bit like looking for a needle in a haystack.
It is, it certainly is, and it was in Lewis's case, absolutely was that. Lewis was tested for Batten disease twice over a period of years, and both times tests came back negative.
For many people, this can be as far as they get. With so many rare diseases sharing symptoms in common, it's often very hard to get a definite diagnosis. Families reach a dead end, no diagnosis and no meaningful treatment. But there are some very helpful things you can do as a parent to help narrow things down.
Well, the first thing that we were advised to do was to keep a diary and videos.
Charlie, where's she gone?
If you had seizures or seizure-like activity, we would video that. And that was all really helpful, because when you go to an appointment, you can say all sorts of things, but you can't show someone.
And that sort of thing can be incredibly helpful for the GP, especially if you haven't reached the stage of being in the hospital system yet. Of course, it can also help the parents to say to the doctor, actually, this isn't right. Here's the proof that things aren't right. Yeah. I think we need to move things on. And then it may well be that at that specialist stage, they can help find out about trials, about clinical research, which might just lead to that diagnosis.
Definitely. We heard about this study, which is called DDD.
That's the Deciphering Developmental Disorders.
That's right, yeah. That's when we did get a result from that, and it was a new variant form of Batten disease, which has not been recognised before.
4 out of 5 people with rare disease will have a genetic cause for it. And looking at the genetic code of those with rare diseases can either confirm a suspected diagnosis or even reveal a new, unsuspected cause. Like many rare diseases, Batten disease is caused by a genetic variant that Lewis inherited from his parents. It affects his nervous system and dramatically shortens his life expectancy without real hope of a cure.
We didn't actually get a diagnosis until last year. So how many years is that? 7?
A lot.
7 years, yeah. I think having a diagnosis has helped us, because we know now that we haven't got that luxury of, yeah, he's going to get better or he'll stay like this for many years. We know that we're on borrowed time. So it makes you just do that extra bit to squeeze everything in that you can.
It's not only Lewis whose life has been turned upside down. A rare disease affects the whole family.
It changes who you are as a person, your life, how you live changes, your priorities change, what you want from life changes. And so I went from being a career person to Lewis's mum and carer. Having someone listen is a massive thing. Your friends tend to drift away. They don't know what to say to you.
Where are you going, eh?
If you're in a relationship, even then it's difficult, because some people can turn to each other and get support from each other, but some people can't. Social media has become our family, basically. SWAN, Syndromes Without a Name, it's a fantastic support group for undiagnosed children.
I know that you and Lewis's dad aren't married anymore, but he's still part of Lewis's life?
Yeah, Lewis absolutely adores his dad, and James Lewis's dad absolutely adores Lewis as well.
Between the two of you, you've got to decide who's best at what. So, you know, I look after all the sort of paperwork around Lewis, I look after the contact with various agencies and doctors, paying the carers and all this sort of stuff around Lewis, which, you know, leaves mum free to do all of the care inside.
Most diseases have support networks, which can be found through Rare Disease UK. And for those awaiting a diagnosis, Syndromes Without a Name, or SWAN, who helped Samantha so much, will offer help, guidance and support.
Don't lose hope and keep on asking questions. If there's something really wrong with your child, you know, and so don't let that go, just keep asking questions.
The DDD project that Lewis took part in has shown how important reading the genetic code letter by letter can be for those with rare disease. Now, the 100,000 Genomes Project has begun work sequencing all the DNA of around 15,000 rare disease patients, together with two of their close relatives. This ambitious project could mean many more people get a proper diagnosis, and for some, that might also mean more effective treatment.
As a GP myself, I know how desperate these situations can be. But help and support is available, even when the treatment options are limited. And participating in research offers real hope for the future.